الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله خاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين اللهم صل وسلم على عبدك ورسولك محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد فيقول الحق سبحانه وتعالى أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم تلك الدار الآخرة نجعلها للذين لا يريدون علوا في الأرض ولا فسادا والعاقبة للمتقين All praises are due to Allah, Lord of the worlds. And I bear witness that Allah is one and has no partners. And that Muhammad, son of Abdullah, is the servant and last messenger, the seal of the prophets. May Allah constantly send peace and blessings to Muhammad and to his family and his companions, to all those who call to his way and practice the sunnah to the day of judgment. As to what follows, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed to us in his glorious book, as for the abode of the hereafter, we assign it to those who do not rebel against the truth with pride, nor do they make mischief by committing crimes, and the good end is for those who are pious, those who fear Allah, those who obey Him and avoid evil. O you who believe, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is rapidly changing the face of this planet. And as we move toward the day of judgment, the day of resurrection, Yawm al-Qiyamah, we are seeing signs constantly coming in front of our eyes. Let us stop and reflect in this month of Ramadan. Allah has revealed شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. Ramadan is the month in which the Quran was revealed, a guidance for people and clear evidence from the guidance and the criteria. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has used Ramadan in many places in history. It is a time of huda, a time of guidance. It is a time of furqan, the separation of good from evil. In these verses that we have heard from Surah Al-Qasas, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed that the true reward in the next life is for those who do not move in the earth with ulu. They are not proud. They are not arrogant ones. They are not calling themselves emperor. They do not raise themselves over the people as a president. They are not kings. They are not people who feel that by their blood or feel that by their wealth or by their color that they are better than other people. Allah has put a condition on the next life that He has made it for those who do not have ulu. He has also made it for those who are not described as having fasad. They are not spreading corruption on the earth. They are not committing crimes and doing evil. But He told us, وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ, that the best reward, the best end, is for those described with taqwa. Those who fear Allah, those who hope in Allah, who surround themselves with the consciousness of Allah, those who avoid evil. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is raising up new leadership from the ruins of the Muslim Ummah. Because of our sins, min al-dhunub, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is punishing us. Because of the bribery, because of intoxicants, of the stealing, of the hoarding of wealth, of all the sins we have committed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making tamhis. He is purifying the Muslim world. But out of this pain, out of this devastation and destruction, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us fursa azima. He has given us opportunities we have never realized in the past. News has come to us from reliable sources, from ulama, from the true scholars who are speaking up in the Muslim world and reporting to us of the truth that is happening. Word has come to us that in Kurdistan, the ulama, along with mujahideen, are controlling major areas in Kurdistan of Iraq. And the believers are coming to them from all sides, coming from the north, coming from the south, deserting from the armies, coming to the leadership and taking bay'ah to the true Islamic leadership. They have told us that there are over 50,000 mujahideen under the sword in Kurdistan, raising up the banner, not based on nationalism, not based on secular teachings, but based upon La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam. They are controlling Arbil, Sulaymaniyya, Kirkuk. They are moving on Mosul. They are coming to take control of an area that they never dreamed they would have the opportunity of controlling in this century. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with His hikmah, has given an opportunity to the believers. In Somalia, a country devastated by war, people fleeing into Ogaden, fleeing down into the south, leaving Mogadishu, no borders, no customs, no passport, complete disorder and folda in the country of Somalia. But out of all this pain, word has come to us from ulama that mujahideen are controlling the south, a large portion of territory, that Muslims who have the proper aqidah, who believe in Allah in the proper way, are controlling an area they never thought they would control in the past. But out of this folda, out of this confusion, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given the opportunity to the believers. In Eritrea, on the coastline of Ethiopia, a country racked with division, a land devastated by continuous war for 20 years, news have come to us from reliable sources that mujahideen are controlling a large section of Eritrea. They are moving on Asmara. They have taken bay'ah to a leader, a bay'ah based upon La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam. An opportunity never existed before, but through the pain and suffering, now being exposed to the believers. In Afghanistan, news has come to us from reliable sources that the mujahideen were not involved in the fitna in the Gulf. They were not those put on the television and made part of the fitna, but they stayed out of the fitna. And that the major groups have allied themselves in a stronger unity than they have seen in months. And they are preparing themselves for a spring offensive to take Kabul and to make Afghanistan, inshallah, the Islamic state that we have all been praying for years. And it is being led now with people who have knowledge and people who have taqwa. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is preparing the Muslim world, bringing us closer to a new world order, not the new world order based upon Bush or based upon the kuffar, but a new world order known to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and revealed to us in hadith. But what about the Western countries? What about these lands, the lands of the kafirun? When Muslims gathered in New York recently, and the imams of many parts of America came together, everyone realized that we have had more opportunity to give the da'wah now than we have had in years. We are entering the schools. We are entering the universities. We are all on the television, on the radio, not secular people representing Islam, but people who have the understanding of Islam now coming forward in a way we never realized before. Only yesterday I had the opportunity to teach a class to 300 elementary students, and we taught them that Islam by the year 2010, inshallah, will be the second largest religion in North America, one out of every five person on the face of the earth is a Muslim. It is the religion of the future. It is the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who taught Moses, the one who taught Jesus, the one who taught Ibrahim, all of the prophets, may Allah send peace to them constantly. And the teachers' faces were red. They were angry. They were in confusion. How could these people come and teach our children about this new world order? This is not the new world order that we thought, that we wanted to teach. But it is out of their hands. It is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He is preparing even the Western world for the coming of the last days. And Allah is giving us signs. He is giving us signs if we would be ulul albab, if we would be people of intelligence, people who would reflect, we would look upon the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And people ask about America. After this destruction, after they now retreat, are retreating back to their safety in their homes, what will happen to them? They now have Patriot missiles. They now have early warning radar systems. How then can any destruction come to them? How then all the things they have done in the world will come back upon them? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed to us in Surah An-Nahl, verse 112. وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا قَرْيَةً كَانَتْ آمِنَةً مُطْمَئِنَّةً يَأْتِيهَا رِزْقُهَا رَغَدًا مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانٍ فَكَفَرَتْ بِأَنْعُمِ اللَّهِ فَأَذَاقَهَا اللَّهُ لِبَاسَ الْجُوعِ وَالْخَوْفِ بِمَا كَانُوا يَصْنَعُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed, and Allah sets forth a parable, a city enjoying security and quiet, abundantly supplied with sustenance from every place. Yet it denied the favors of Allah. So Allah made it taste of hunger and terror, closing in on it like a clothing from every side because of the evil the people had committed. Then what about America? What about the Patriot missiles? What about the radar system? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ready to take even these lands, He will take them, and there is no system that can warn the people or protect the people from His punishment when it hits. Only yesterday, tornadoes struck the land of America. Winds reported to be moving at 130 kilometers. Trucks were thrown like toys. Trees ripped from the ground and thrown like sticks. Even in Sarnia, in Ontario, it is reported that they heard a noise. It sounded like a roaring train. And then the wind struck. Aseha. It is the call. It is that sound that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unleashed upon Qawmu'ad and Thamud and those who came before. Do not think that Allah would leave these people alone. If they cause destruction, Allah will send His punishment upon them, and no Patriot missile, no early warning system, no form of man-made technology would save them from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is revealing His signs, and He has given these signs on the lips of the last Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. In Muslim reports on the authority of Hudhayfa al-Ghaffari radiyallahu an, that the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, as Hudhayfa said, came upon us and we were studying. Natadhakir. He said, what are you studying? And then Hudhayfa said, As-sa'ah. We are studying the hour. And the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, said, إِنَّهَا لَمْ تَقُومَ حَتَّى تَرَوْا قَبْلَهَا عَشْرَ آيَاتٍ فَذَكَرَ الدُّخَانِ وَالدَّجَّالِ وَالدَّابَّةِ وَتُلُوءِ الشَّمْسِ مِنْ مَغْرِبِهَا وَنُزُولُ عِيسَى بْنِ مَرْيَمَ ويأجوج ومأجوج وثلاثة خسوف خسف بالمشرق وخسف بالمغرب وخسف بجزيرة العرب وآخر ذلك نار تخرج من اليمن من قعر عدن تسوق الناس إلى المحشر. The Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, told the Muslims who was studying the hour with Hudhayfa radiallahu anhu. He said, the last hour would not come until you see 10 signs. Then he mentioned Ad-Dukhan, smoke, the Dajjal, the Antichrist, Ad-Dabba, a creature who would speak all languages and terrify people, the sun rising in the west, the descent of Jesus, the son of Mary, peace be upon him, Gog and Magog, Ya'juj and Ma'juj, and three lunar eclipses, one in the east, one in the west, one in the Arabian Peninsula, and the last sign would be a fire coming out of Yemen at the lower part of Aden, which would drive the people toward the area of the resurrection. People ask, how could these signs appear? How could a fire of such power and velocity appear on the earth? How could smoke appear like this when smoke is released in the air and it becomes nothing? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us early warning of the signs, the fire, the Dukhan, the fires are burning in Kuwait. It is burning an underground sea of oil. We do not know if and when they will put it out. The Dukhan, smoke is coming from the fire. The smoke is rising to the atmosphere. The temperature has lowered 60 degrees in Kuwait. People with heart trouble are dying. The smoke is coming into their noses, coming into their mouths. It is said on occasions, the visibility is only 500 meters. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us early warning of the signs of Qiyamah. When the real smoke comes, the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, on the authority of Hudhayfa, radiallahu anh, reports. And Hudhayfa said, what is Dukhan? The Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, revealed that Dukhan will fill up what is between the east and the west. It will last arba'ina yawman wa layla. It will last 40 days and nights. For the believer, it would be like a bad cold with a cough. But for the disbeliever, it will be like he is sakran. It will be like he is drunk. Smoke will come out their nostrils. Smoke will come out their ears, out of their backside, on all of their bodies. And the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, has promised the coming of Dukhan. What about Isa alayhi salam? We are now on a day that they call Good Friday. And the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, has told us, خَيْرُ يَوْمٌ تَلَعَدْ فِيهِ الشَّمْسِ يَوْمُ الْجُمْعَةِ. It is the best day in which the sun has arisen, not only once per year, but every Jumu'ah is the best day, and all those who are here today should be attending their Jumu'ah, especially the men who have reached maturity. It is compulsory to have your Jumu'ah, and beware that the time is coming when Isa alayhi salam would appear on this earth. In authentic hadith, the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, has reported, by Allah, the son of Maryam is about to descend. Hakaman muqsita. He will be a just ruler. He will break the salib. He will break the crosses. He will kill the khinzir, kill the swine. He will lift the jizya tax, and wealth will flow so that nobody would even take charity. And one prostration would be better than a dunya wa ma fiha. One prostration, one sijda, would be better than this world and everything inside of it. O you who believe, what we are seeing today in front of us, in these lands of the kafirun, it is a hoax. It is a lie on Allah and His messengers. Palm Sunday, Ash Wednesday, Good Friday, Easter Sunday, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed, وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ وَلَكِنْ شُبِّهَ لَهُمْ. He was not killed. Isa was not killed. He was not crucified. It was made to appear to them. Tashbih. And so they have created on this false image their religion. And they are leading people astray. They are leading people saying that God Himself must appear to die on the cross. But we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven Adam alayhi salam. He has forgiven Hawa. And all those prophets who raised their hand in dua, that their dua is mustajab. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave them. So there was no need for God to come down on a cross and give his life. This is another religion. This is the pagan religion of the kafirun that existed for many centuries on the face of the planet Earth. When Isa alayhi salam comes, it will be a serious time. All believers will be called to jihad. He will not come as a person throwing flowers. He will break the crosses, kill the swine. No more jizya. That means either Islam or war. It is the time of war when Isa alayhi salam comes. He will live by the Quran, not as a new prophet, but he will come to finalize what was said by the last prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. He will live out his life. He will die a natural death because every soul must taste death. But when he comes to these lands, how will you be إِذَا نَزَلَ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمَ? How will you be when he comes? Will you be afraid to stand by his side? Will you be so confused in following the Christians and the Jews? He will not know you are Muslim. How will he distinguish between you and between the Yahud and Nasara if you are following them into a lizard's hole, as the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, has told us? How will Isa alayhi salam know who you are? How will he put you into the ranks of the believers? How will you escape the Dajjal when he comes and brings the worst test that will be ever recorded in history? How will you be when that time comes? Pray to Allah in the month of Ramadan. Take your fast as a test from Allah. Take it as a purification for the things you have done wrong. Purify your mind and prepare yourself for the new world order. The Mujahideen are raising up all over the Muslim world. We are called here to do the da'wah. We are called to stand up for Islam on our jobs. Stand up for Islam at school. Stand up for Islam in the streets. Do not base your call on nationalism. Do not base your call on sectarianism. Do not divide one organization against another. We are all believers and we should be prepared to forgive our brothers and sisters, to come together with any masjid, any center that is practicing Islam and wanting to look not at the past, but to look at the future based upon striving for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah give us this feeling of taqwa and unity. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us for the wrongs that we have done. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive the Muslim world for the sins that exist in it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purify the Muslim world of any other sin. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raise up the leadership with the Mujahideen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give Jannah to the Shuhada. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us and have mercy of us in Ramadan, for we know not what we do. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفُرُ لَلِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ مُسْلِمِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ ذَنْبٍ إِسْتَغْفِرُوا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد وأصلي وأسلم على خاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد, يا عباد الله, اتقوا الله تعالى حق تقاته. O you who believe, the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, as revealed to us about Ramadan, وشهر أوله رحمة وأوسطه مغفرة وآخره عتق من النار. It is a month in which its beginning is mercy, its middle is forgiveness, and the last part of the month is freedom from the fire. We are now in the time of the Maghfirah. We are in the middle portion of the month. The fast is now resting in our bodies. It is purifying our blood. But we should remember to purify our mouths, not to be involved in backbiting and namima, not to be involved in bakhshish not to be involved in stealing, bribery, and all of the lower characteristics. It is a total imsak. Imsak not only from water and from food, it is imsak from ma'siyah. Stay away from the sins. Come together with your brothers and sisters. The Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, was described in this month as giving the wealth like a gentle breeze, a breeze that gives. And so we should open up our pocket, the wealth Allah has given to us. Give to the mujahideen. Give to the fuqara and masakeen. Give to any movement supporting Islam. Do not be tied down by hayat al-dunya. And remember that death is close to us. And Allah has given us ibrah. He has given us signs. He has taken members of our families. He has taken our friends. He has taken our neighbors. And our time also is soon. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us purification before our death. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the strength to be strong in these times. And may Allah give us the feeling to always send peace and blessings to Muhammad. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. And may Allah be pleased with him and the Khulafa al-Rashideen, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman and Ali. Pleased with them and us, Ya Arhamar Rahimeen. Alhamdulillah, الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. ربنا إنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا وآتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا تقبل صيامنا وقيامنا. ربنا تقبل صيامنا وقيامنا. ربنا تقبل صيامنا وقيامنا. ربنا تقبل أعمالنا كلها في شهر رمضان. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداء الدين وانصر عبادك يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر المجاهدين في كردستان وفي أفغانستان وفي فلسطين وفي إريتريا وصوماليا وكل مكان يا رب العالمين. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات. O Allah, have mercy on the sick of the Ummah of Muhammad. Have mercy on Halaqa. Have mercy on...